Elle Mills has become a sort of poster child for YouTuber burnout. But in this video, we're gonna be talking about, is it burnout or is it something more that all of us can relate to? What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel is all about mental health. And what I like to do is pull different topics from the YouTube community to try to teach you how to improve your mental and emotional well-being. So if you're into that stuff, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And speaking of subscribing and ringing that notification bell, do I have some exciting news for you. Today is the day where we officially launch the podcast. All right, so this podcast is going to be called Unsolicited Advice, but it's not just with me, it's with my boy, Matt, from the channel Create You. So I know a ton of you have been waiting for this podcast for months and months and months, and we are officially launching it today. So make sure you go subscribe to our channel, Unsolicited Advice. It'll be linked down in the description and in the pinned comments. And we're gonna be recording it every single Tuesday, and it will be available on all devices and different streaming services on Wednesdays. All right, we're gonna be talking about mental health, YouTube, addiction recovery, news, all sorts of that stuff, all right? But anyways, yeah, so we're gonna be talking about, in this video, people like Elle Mills, Lilly Singh, YouTubers as a whole experiencing burnout, but there's an interesting kind of spin on it that I never even thought of before. And right now you're like, but Chris, if you never thought of it before, what's this video gonna be like? Well, that's even more interesting because remember that guy Matt I told you about? Well, check this out.
Hi, I'm Elle Mills. My childhood dream was to be a YouTuber.
I'm Louis Cole. I have a channel from Louis.
Welcome to Ear Biscuits. I'm Link.
And I'm Red. This week at the Roundtable of Dim Lighting, we are
exploring the question.
And recently,
today's upload is a commentary video about this article that Insider put out about
YouTubers burning out.
Screw this. Chris, from the bottom of my heart, thank you so much for allowing me to be a guest on your channel and to introduce myself to all your wonderful Rewired soldiers. And for all you guys, my name is Matt with Create You, where I try to focus on putting you back into the creative process. Now, one of the issues and trends I've been following on YouTube since early last year has been this entire topic of burnout. Creator burnout, YouTuber burnout, and all this. We've seen it trending crazily on YouTube and in the mainstream media right now. And there's an example that's floating around in my world right now. And since I saw it, it's just not set well with me. And it's Lilly Singh. Back in November, we saw a video from her basically saying she's gonna take a break from YouTube. And then quickly thereafter, we saw continuing uploads and nothing really changed. And I kind of was left there going, well, I thought you were going to take a break from this, but I guess you didn't. You know, and as I was watching the video, certain things she was mentioning about YouTube being a machine and kind of forcing you just to continue to pump out content or, you know, trying to find the reflection of your true self. And even at towards the end of the video, when she started talking about how the way we utilize numbers as creators being relevant or not relevant, a lot of these things just really didn't sit well with me and led me to start a line of questioning, which I think we as people and creators should be asking ourselves. So let's talk about this YouTuber burnout thing in a little bit more detail. See, last year, Elle Mills released a video, Burnout at 19, and it became this like overnight success, this trend almost, of YouTubers wanting to take a step back from creating because they were feeling burnt out. And the reality is the video released by Elle Mills was actually really good. She talked about a lot of the symptoms that are very diagnosable inside of burnout itself. And I want to commend Elle Mills for taking that leap. However, there's this twist to it as we saw the conversation of mental health in general escalate tremendously on the platform of YouTube, in mainstream media, and even with you guys as viewers. Now, all of this is actually really good. We should be having a conversation about mental health. But when we start seeing videos like Lily's pop up, where she says, hey, I'm going to be taking a step back from YouTube in order to address something important, as it should be, her mental health, as is all of our mental health important. But then the behavior doesn't really back up that statement. You know, the continuing uploads that followed and the merch line that got pushed thereafter. There were just some indicators there that said, well, she's saying one thing, but doing another. What does this mean? Is this really burnout, or is there something more going on here? So let's talk about this burnout thing, this thing everybody keeps talking about, because the reality is it actually is a diagnosable condition. And if you want more information, you can actually check out Katie Morton's video on burnout, where she does a great job doing a deep dive into a lot of the symptoms and kind of perpetuating back end that actually creates burnout. Chris, this is for you. Put a link. To sum up exactly what happens inside of someone who is experiencing burnout, what they're actually experiencing is a lack of fulfillment in something they are doing. And this lack of fulfillment can come from anything: your job, your career, school, maybe college, a relationship with your partner, your family, anything. You can get burned out on anything, because at the end of the day, it's a feeling that what you're putting into something, you are not receiving back. And this is where I think we need to start taking a deep dive into this burnout thing. See, because burnout is such a broad thing and it can affect creators and non-creators alike, and while I have a tendency to focus on small creators on my channel, but try to spread the message to non-creators alike, we almost have to reverse engineer the process of burnout, where it starts, where it leads to, and then how best to avoid it and protect ourselves from future burnout. The first thing we need to recognize is that every engagement in our lives is building a relationship, okay? Humans by nature demand relationships. We seek relationships out. So whether it's a relationship with your partner or your job or your career or school, you have to understand that all these things in your life replicate the same relationship patterns in your brain. It's one reason we can say we hate our job and we love our partner and we love our car. These are all relationship building blocks inside of our brain. More than this, we can develop healthy relationships and incredibly unhealthy relationships as well. Look at somebody inside of an abusive relationship. Anyone with some logic and a rationale to them would look at this person inside of an abusive relationship and say, oh my God, you need to stop this. Get out of that relationship. It's horrible. It's bad. Stop it. But for some reason, the abused inside of that relationship refuses to leave the relationship and in turn stays. And this doesn't make any sense when we look at it. This same type of abusive relationship can be seen outside of a romantic relationship, inside of your job, where people work too much. They're putting too much of their time into work and not themselves, so they become overworked. It becomes very unhealthy. We can look at the same thing inside of a relationship that a YouTuber has with their YouTube channel. They spend so much time invested into it, not recognizing the damage it is doing to them and those around themselves. This is an unhealthy relationship. And we have to stop here and go, well, if this is how we see an unhealthy relationship happen, what do we do to stop it? And this brings us to boundaries, healthy boundaries. You as an individual, before you can engage in a healthy relationship, you need to know what healthy boundaries are. Boundaries are incredibly important for you, for me, for the creator, for the non-creator. Your boundaries are what keeps you from being hurt by an abusive boyfriend or girlfriend, being overworked by an employer who does not respect you as a human being. It keeps you safe and it keeps you grounded at all times and throughout your day. Having healthy, personal, emotional, mental boundaries in your life is what will prevent you from being abused by your partner. It's what will prevent you from overinvesting into YouTube. It will help you prevent yourself from investing too much time watching YouTube, because that's a problem as well. In all cases, our boundaries are what keeps us protected, safe, and centered in self. But this leads us to, how do we create healthy boundaries for ourselves? Self-worth. This right here is really the start of healthy boundaries. See, in a lot of cases, people do not understand their own worth. More often than not, people determine their sense of worth and value by external facets of their life. Their job, their career, their college education, what their degree is in, the value of your home, how much you take home, how much Starbucks you can afford. Maybe it's your friends list on Facebook, if anybody still uses Facebook anymore. Your social media presence, and something like YouTube, if you're a creator, it could be the amount of followers you have on Instagram, the amount of subscribers you have on YouTube, the likes, the views, the clicks you receive on your videos. In many, many cases, people have this horrible tendency to determine their sense of worth and value upon external facets of their lives. And at the end of the day, this leaves them feeling hopeless and helpless and depressed and unfulfilled, because it does not come from themselves. No amount of worth found from an external source will ever leave you feeling fulfilled, because it's a constant chase for more. No amount of clicks will ever make a creator feel good. They will always want more clicks. No amount of subscribers will ever make a YouTuber feel good, because they're always going to be hunting for more. No amount of money for you as a professional will ever make you feel good enough or worth it enough or worthwhile enough for anyone, especially you. And it's because it's an external force. It does not come from your spirit. So how do we address worthwhileness? How do we address self-worth? You are the answer to all your problems. Only through self-discovery, self-awareness, will you ever come to a place where you understand yourself. Because the harsh reality is, we as people are not born with worth. When we are children and coming up as young adults, we do not understand ourselves enough to understand our own value and to understand our own worth and what makes us feel worthwhile. This is a journey. It's a discovery to determine, who am I? What is it that makes me tick as a human being? What is my value that when I look at myself, I can say, I, Matt, have this inherent worth and this value I can give to others? That process is key. It is important. And unfortunately, many people will not go through this process because it is quite difficult and long, but the rewards are so worth it. If you can find you, if you determine who you are, what makes you tick, who you are as an individual, you will naturally develop a healthy sense of worth, which will then in turn build healthy boundaries for you, and then you can have healthy relationships. But it all starts with you. Unfortunately, a lot of people don't want to hear this. People would rather blame other things or other people for their lack of happiness or lack of feeling worthwhile. And this is very, very unfortunate, because at the end of the day, taking accountability of ourselves, taking responsibility of ourselves is incredibly liberating, because it forces us to further our relationship with ourself and to truly get down to understand who we are. This is especially evident inside of the YouTube community, where you have YouTube creators constantly blaming YouTube, saying that YouTube should be doing more and that YouTube doesn't do enough for small creators, or that YouTube forces us into this mentality to upload more and maintain relevance, when all of this is a blatant excuse, is all it is. YouTube forces you to do nothing, just like nobody will ever force you to do anything. You are strong enough to choose. You are strong enough to take accountability, to take responsibility for yourself. And it's something that I preach all the time. Take responsibility, take accountability. You will find empowerment inside of that accountability. You know, it's scary to think about, but, you know, while Lilly Singh may not be the mental health YouTuber we all have been looking for or wanted or need, I mean, unless she had done that video, it would not have allowed us this opportunity to have this conversation. So, God, maybe she's the one we actually deserve. How scary is that? Chris, back to you.
Yo, in case you were wondering why Matt is my co-host, that right there is why Matt is my co-host. When he showed me this video, I'm like, dude, you might have missed your calling. You might be the one who needs a mental health channel. And I just love how he intertwined relationships and boundaries, self-worth, and brought it back to that thing that we preach here, which is accountability, right? Accountability, which is empowering. I love it. So if that doesn't give you a reason to check out our new channel and podcast, Unsolicited Advice, I don't know what is. All right, but anyways, again, thanks, Matt, for coming over here. I'm so glad you made this video. It gave me some stuff to think about as well. I want to hear from all of you down in the comments below. Can you relate to what he was talking about with your relationships, your boundaries issues, your self-worth being tied into different things? Let's have a conversation down below. And this is actually going to be part of the topic for our very first episode, which is premiering tonight. So make sure you go subscribe to our new channel, Unsolicited Advice. Turn on the notification bells and stay tuned, because we got some really exciting stuff coming soon, all right? But anyways, that's all I got for this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And a huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. You are all amazing. And I just posted the February Q&A. So if you are a patron, make sure you go over there, ask your questions. I will be filming that later this month. If you would like to ask questions and have them answered, click or tap on that Patreon icon right there, all right? Thanks again for watching. We'll see you next time.